Hey guys, in this video we're going to do a tutorial on Persona Studio 1.4. This will be part of a multi-part series that covers a lot of the basic features of this program, from audio recording and mixing to MIDI and virtual instruments. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so you get notified whenever we release a new video in this series. Alright, so to get started we need to download the software from Persona's website. To do that, we need to sign up for an account with our email address. Remember the username and password you use for this, since you'll use it to activate the software and sign in once it's installed. As some of you may know, there's a few different versions of Studio One available. The Prime version has some limitations to it, but it's free that lasts forever. On the other hand, there's a fully featured 30-day trial available for the full version, or you can purchase the full version from the website. For more information on the differences, you can check out the website for a comparison table and determine which version works best for you. Either way, most of the basics that are covered in the series will apply to all the versions. We'll try and keep our tutorial to the Prime version, that way everyone can follow along. Once you're on the Persona's website, download the version you're looking to install and install it from the Downloads folder. When you run the program for the first time, you'll be asked to install some additional software. I've chosen to do that in my version, and you can do the same as well. Before we actually get started on the project, we should make sure our audio interface is configured. This is done from the main screen when the program launches. We select the audio interface from the middle bottom section, and I'll be using my Focusrite USB audio interface. This is a Focusrite Scarlett 18i20 interface. I'm using this since it has a lot of different inputs and outputs, and it's a great audio interface for home recording. We've done a separate video on this audio interface on the channel, and if you're looking to get one for yourself, you can check out our links in the video description. Once you're ready to start your project, press the Create a Song button in the top left. We'll leave it as Empty Song. You can select the folder that's saved in and the title of the project. Now is also the chance to set the project's sample rate and resolution. I'll be using 44.1 kHz for this project, but you can use a higher sample rate if you wish. I do recommend leaving it as 24-bit. Now press the OK button at the bottom to start the new project. Alright, now we can see we have the blank project. Let's just take a look around to see where everything is. The top bar gives us a few editing tools to select, split, erase, and draw on our tracks. To the right of that, we have some quantization tools and settings for the grid bars and snapping. At the bottom of the screen, the main thing to look at are the buttons in the center, which allow us to navigate through a song, play, stop, and record. Then we've got some metronome settings, tempo, and time signature for the project. For the most part, you'll usually want to make sure you use a metronome if you plan on using virtual instruments in MIDI. It usually makes it a lot easier to work with. We just have to click on the tempo and timing to be able to make the adjustments. The metronome can be turned on with the triangle button on the right above the word metronome. The left circle gives us a count in at the beginning when we start recording, and I would recommend turning this on as well. The center wrench is for settings. That opens a window for more advanced metronome controls like controlling the length of the count-in and the volume of the clicks. Thanks for checking out this video on getting started with Persona Studio 1. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video, and be sure to check out the rest of the series on the software as well.